So today we're going to talk about the visual system, which is far more than what we tend to imagine, this sort of idea of our eyes being cameras that replicate information from the outside world. Of course, I'm going to tell you it's much more complicated than that. My name's Virginia Spielmann. I'm the executive director here at the Star Institute for Sensory Processing Disorder in Greenwood Village, Colorado. And we're doing a sort of tour of all the sensory systems at the moment, and today we're talking about the visual system. The visual system, the hardware we're all aware of, is these two orbs floating around in our head, very, very sophisticated pieces of hardware. And what we commonly think of when we think we might have something going on with our visual system is the need to go to the opticians. You have to go, you have to get your eyes tested. Which is better, this or this, this or this, this or this? Then we think, okay, great, I've had my eyes tested, everything's in order, perhaps I've got a prescription, perhaps I don't need one yet. But of course, there's so much more to it than that. And again, we've hit some themes in our videos. The visual system is also very much, has a lot to do with emotional coding of situations as well. So there's sensory emotional component to the visual system, and part of the visual system's job is to keep us alive. Now, it's really interesting with the visual system how that works. So let's go there first. The eyes are hardwired by the optic nerve to almost every level of the brain, every level of function, from very low, sort of what we call the central nervous system level, which is in charge of some pretty important pieces for us. For example, if we want our eyes to be able to stay stable and keep the line of the horizon fixed, we don't want them floating around in our head and we're wobbling like those creepy baby doll's eyes that roll up and down and to the side. So there's a reflex that's responsible for that, where the vestibular system and the visual system work together, and they need to work together in an integrated way in order to keep the horizon stable and to keep our eyes stable in our heads. You know, we can move our heads around as much as we like and we should have a stable visual field. Incredibly important for keeping us alive. We've also got our peripheral vision, which has very, it's wired for safety. It has a big job in keeping us safe. And if something in our peripheral system moves without us expecting it, our brain very quickly needs to file away that piece of data. Do I need to orient to that? Am I under threat or can I ignore it? And so we have all these functions of the visual system that are for just basic maintenance of life. Another one is it's responsible for helping us sleep at night, wake in the morning, be functioning during the day. It has a huge, huge influence on what we call our circadian rhythms. And again, maintaining life. Really, really important functions. This is all, I emphasize all of this because we tend to, as I said at the beginning, oversimplify the job of the visual system, and we think it's either about glasses, and if we're being really thorough, we might look at visual processing and how a child perhaps looks at shapes on paper and 3D objects, and we forget the vast scope and the massive responsibility of the visual system, again, through every level of the brain. So maintenance of life is a really important part of the influence the visual system has on our brain, on our brain-body connections, on our function as a human being. It's also wired to the frontal lobe and helps us with really high-level decision-making. It helps us with exquisite motor planning and even the most basic motor planning. Yes, it helps us in the classroom to see the teacher. We have to filter out so much visual information all the time and be deciding what's important and what we need to pay attention to. There's also a part of the brain that is exclusively responsible for taking in neutral visual information and adding a value to it that's emotional. Is this positive, neutral, negative? That's where visual affective integration takes place. Most important point being that it does take place. The visual data that comes into our brains is ascribed some emotional properties as we process it. It's not just a camera, taking a photo or taking a video of the world and storing it away in our memories. So there's so many pieces to visual processing that you could do a 3-day course on it. You could probably do a PhD on it and not be finished in studying the importance of this system. But really, I wanted to emphasize how important it is for maintenance of life and all the way through, how it's wired to every level of the brain, and it really impacts the majority of our function. It is the system we tend to rely on the most, and sometimes we rely on it so much because we're not great in other sensory systems that it's to our detriment, it becomes a problem. Sometimes we have a hard time filtering out visual information that's not important. Think about all the things I've just said, and if they were to go wrong, how they would impact your activities of daily living, your ability to participate in the classroom and in the community. There's so much like understanding the visual scene, depth perception, visual memory, perception of motion, where am I and how am I moving? And that's a really important one too. Vision contributes a great deal to our ability to move successfully in the world. And so if we can't discriminate what's going on visually in the environment, if we're over responsive, if we're under responsive, that's all gonna cause problems. And we might do things like filter out some information by using our hands, by closing our eyes, by scrunching our eyes, by making our world visually small. We might need to find some adaptive strategies like colored sunglasses and different things like that to help us be more functional. And we also might look like we're seeking visual information to help make the world look more organized when it's actually the visual information that's disorganizing us in the first place. Going back to the maintaining life aspect of the visual system, our eyes are also a really important part of the postural part of sensory processing. And so staying upright and having our eyes organized in space and being able to look and use both of our eyes together is a part of sensory processing. And so when we have postural disorders and visual challenges, that can really impact our ability to sit upright in the classroom, pay attention, coordinate the two sides of our body, move around in space. It's an incredibly important system. It needs a lot of attention when it is disordered to really pinpoint what's going on so that we can provide the right interventions. And so this was just a taster in a much broader topic. Let us know if you have questions. I threw a lot of information at you just then, so put them in the comments below. And next time we're going to talk about the tactile system.